An invisible threat puts your family's health in danger. Last night, the NBC2 investigators told you about radon, the radioactive gas that's often not tested for in Florida.
Tonight, we're looking at schools. It is federally recommended that Florida schools test for radon every 5 years. NBC2 investigator Rachel Polansky uncovers that is not happening in Southwest Florida.
When this North Fort Myers dad drops his daughter off at school,
my daughter's name is Jada.
He worries about how she'll do in class.
She likes reading.
He's never worried about her health until today.
And if there's something that could be seeping through the floor or something somewhere, they should at least check for it once a year.
We told Lee Grooms about radon, the radioactive gas that can enter homes or schools from soil or building materials and seep through cracks and openings in the foundation. It's colorless, odorless, tasteless, and the CDC says it's the number one cause of lung cancer among non-smokers. Jada Grooms' school, Bayshore Elementary, hasn't tested for radon since 1997.
It's kind of scary to think she's here all day while I'm working and she could be breathing something in, you know.
The NBC2 investigators pulled records from the Florida Department of Health dating back to 1994. And out of the 83 public and private schools that have been tested for radon in Lee County, 64 of them, or 77%, have not been tested since 1996. Out of the 42 that have been tested in Collier County, 37 or 88% of them have not been tested since 1996. And the schools are not doing anything wrong because mandatory radon testing is not required in either county.
To me, as a public health expert, that's frightening.
Dr. Matthew Shabath, an epidemiologist at Moffitt Cancer Center in Tampa, was shocked when we told him about the lack of radon testing taking place in Southwest Florida schools.
The data shows unequivocally there are pockets throughout the state of Florida in any given county, even those low-risk counties, where you can find a given building or given room within a building where you have very high levels of radon.
And he says this is not a one-time measurement. Just because a classroom tested low for radon 20 years ago does not mean that it will test low today. And that goes both ways. A classroom that once tested high for radon could show low levels today.
It's like a flowing river where it can ebb and flow. It's something that requires constant measurements over time.
Now, Charlotte County does have to test its schools for radon because of where it's located on this Florida radon protection map. But it's only required in brand new schools. I asked Charlotte County Public School spokesperson Mike Riley if he thinks that all schools should be tested.
We rely upon the experts at the State Department of Education and the state of Florida. If they feel that that's the correct amount of time for us, that's what we're doing.
So what happens if schools do find elevated levels of radon? According to the Florida statute, mitigation is recommended, but the state does not require any action.
The last testing we've done are the two newest schools that we've built.
Public records confirm that radon tests were performed at Lemon Bay High School in 2016 and Meadow Park Elementary in 2018. Both schools had low levels of radon.
So what determines a low or high level of radon? The gas is measured in picocuries per liter, and levels of 4 or more is considered hazardous. Since 1994, the NBC2 investigators found 23 schools in Southwest Florida that had classrooms with radon levels over 4 picocuries. In Charlotte County, we found one classroom that hit 38 and another that hit 48.
Is this a legitimate concern?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, this goes back to the analogy. Would you fill a room with cigarette smoke and let your kid sit in there?
Lee Groom says he wouldn't.
I don't let my kid ride in the car with someone who smokes.
And now he wants some answers from his school district and his state lawmakers.
I would definitely like to know that somebody's checking into it.
Neither the Lee nor Collier County School District agreed to participate in our story. Now, I've also reached out to several lawmakers, and so far, only State Senator Kathleen Pasadomo has told me that she's looking into these issues. You can see the last time that your child's school tested for radon and what those levels were at NBC-2.com. For the NBC2 investigators tonight, I'm Rachel Polansky.